Are you ready?
You think you can tell us what to do? You think you can tell us what to wear? You think that you're better? Well, you better get ready. Bow to the masters.
For one fall, approaching the ring first, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, The Game, Triple H, D-Generation X.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, right now you are looking at one of the most entertaining, controversial, and of course successful tag teams in the history of world wrestling entertainment. It is D-Generation X.
Well, there's chaos in the back, but ladies and gentlemen, I'm never used to that. It always gets me. I was going to talk about this Sunday and inside Hell in a Cell. We're going to find out just how proficient Legacy really is. Legacy got the upper hand over DX at Breaking Point when they submitted Shawn Michaels. There just may be a different song sung in 2 days on pay-per-view.
Can DX end Legacy before they can be fully established? We'll find out Sunday night. John Cena, who is the current WWE champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, he has always been successful.
We're about to have a cataclysmic showdown here at our main event. is for and the legacy with Randy Orton, Cody Rhodes, and Ted DiBiase appear to be primed for battle.
Perhaps much of the future of legacy and Randy Orton will be written over the next 48 hours as far as their WWE careers are concerned. Specifically, Randy Orton has a chance inside Satan's structure to wrestle the WWE title away from that man, John Cena. The last time that Orton and Cena got together at Breaking Point, it was uncomfortable to watch, quite frankly. The physicality, the intensity will go up in 48 hours.
Tonight, CM Punk said that he, the straight-edge superstar, can save you. It's prohibition rules here tonight, according to the World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, CM Punk will come out of the, as The Undertaker described, the Black Forest, a self-righteousness. This Sunday, inside Hell in a Cell, a match that I really believe was designed for The Undertaker back in the day. Undertaker was in the first one. I sat here at ringside and called it. I'm not sure that CM Punk, as dangerous as he is and as confident as he is, knows what Punk is stepping into on Sunday. It's just, it's beyond description.
It is wicked torturous, as they would say here in Boston. Does CM Punk have what it takes?
Referee calls for the bell. This should be a mind-bending eight-man tag team matchup. I would think that perhaps Legacy and Orton, along with CM Punk, may have a little bit of an advantage simply because of the three-man unit of Legacy.
JR, you've been doing this for a long time. Have you ever called a match with this much star power that we're seeing tonight?
Never have, Todd, and it's so special here on Friday Night SmackDown. I'm very privileged to be a part of this as John Cena starts out against Cody Rhodes.
It has been a fantastic night so far. A decade of SmackDown, 10 years, and this is certainly a main event fitting of the occasion.
John Cena got his start right here on Friday Night SmackDown. That's confrontational on his first night, as he is tonight. Cena going for the cover. Cena about to make this historic main event somewhat short-lived.
Cena punched Kurt Angle right in the face his first night, and now Triple H is about to get his shots in on Cody Rhodes. Triple H, a 13-time world champion.
Cody Rhodes, the son of the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, quick to make the tag to Ted DiBiase, whose father is the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase.
And JR, Legacy have promised to end the DX era at Hell in a Cell. Probably not a lot of people are believing that, but at the same time, no one thought they'd win in that submission match. But they did.
Again, Ted got some wrath on young DiBiase here with those sledgehammer-like right hands. I certainly didn't call the winner at Breaking Point. I thought DX would have won that submission tag team match. Balls counted anywhere in Montreal. But it was a Legacy night. Can they make it two in a row? We're gonna find out in 2 days.
Triple H, a neck breaker, goes into a cover and a two count. And on SmackDown, we've got some great young up-and-coming superstars. We saw them earlier, Dolph Ziggler, John Morrison, just to name a few. Where do you rank Cody Rhodes and Ted DiBiase?
Well, they're right there with them. They're part of that young foundation that's ever-evolving in WWE. It's going to be so exciting to see all these young men progress and grow. And they can put Legacy, speaking of Legacy, can take a tag match to Shawn Michaels, take a big step forward. Edge chop. How can I do that for you later?
You can try. With Ted DiBiase quickly turning defense into offense. Shawn Michaels, the showstopper.
Oh, Michaels just lured DiBiase in. You could almost feel it and see it coming. Michaels is the ultimate maestro.
Got the little tag.
He's thinking about,
oh, look at this.
Pick your poison.
Undertaker, Shawn Michaels.
WrestleMania 25. And boy, DiBiase didn't want the Undertaker in. Good one, Michaels, to make a tag.
DiBiase canceled the vote, but a tag was made. The Undertaker is in.
And the Undertaker lowering the boom on Cody Rhodes, who got the tag. These combustible elements, will they implode? Who will win as SmackDown rolls on?
We're back here on Friday Night SmackDown. You're watching an eight-man tag match. The Undertaker going for the cover on Cody Rhodes in a kickout. And the dead man right now imposing his will on Legacy's Cody Rhodes.
The Undertaker, DX, and John Cena against Randy Orton, CM Punk, the world's champion, and Legacy. Eight-man tag. The strength here. Balance, strength of Triple H. The game. Sending a message to Cody Rhodes. His blood is rushing to his brain.
Now that's a standing vertical suplex if I've ever seen one. That's hang time.
That is a message, a loud physical message sent to Legacy by DX, specifically the game.
On Monday Night Raw, Triple H said, hey, we're like Bruce Banner, but we'll turn into the Incredible Hulk. The monster will come out at Hell in the Cell.
Michaels with a tag, knife edge chopping. Rhodes gets a couple of solid right hands. Michaels tenaciously holding on to Rhodes, but to Michaels' own misery.
You like it, huh? And that was some venom being shown there by Cody Rhodes, perhaps taking a page out of the book of Randy Orton.
Well, we saw the game send a message earlier to Cody Rhodes, and now Ted DiBiase is returning it and sending a message to Shawn Michaels.
And now Randy Orton.
He is
the Viper.
The Viper indeed. Slithering his way into the ring. And look at this. Referee has a big challenge, keeping his eyes on eight individuals. It's really an impossible situation for the official. He's doing a great job.
And quickly a tag man, and here's CM Punk, the first ever straight edge world champion. Picking up the pieces of a battered Shawn Michaels.
Punk will venture into the domain of the Undertaker.
Look at Cody Rhodes again.
Cheap shots.
Legacy.
The messages are being sent from one corner to the other. From inside the ring to outside the ring. All these agendas that I'll cultivate in 2 days. And a nice back suplex by CM Punk on Shawn Michaels.
And now Punk with a cover. And a kick out there from Shawn Michaels. Every one of these superstars you're seeing in this main event match tonight will be inside Hell in a Cell Sunday night. What kind of condition will they be in?
Michaels in a very vulnerable state, and Michaels knew it. Shawn knew what was coming because Orton is so destructive. And Orton's so hell-bent on becoming the WWE Champion again. And Orton gets that chance on pay-per-view in 2 days.
We've seen what kind of damage Randy Orton can do at Breaking Point. The punishment he dished out on John Cena was unprecedented. Cena took a hellacious beating from the Viking.
Michaels neck crimped at a very dangerous angle. Michaels looking at his corner. The eyes of Shawn Michaels has told me that he is in big time trouble. Look at Orton trying to wrench the neck of Michaels and do a Legacy a favor. John Cena looking to make a tag, wants to make a tag.
And Michaels now has that breathing room. Can HBK get one of his three partners in the ring?
Well, Michaels created separation. That's what he had to do. But now can Michaels make a tag?
Cody Rhodes is in. Michaels stretching out his right arm. Can he get the tag made? Oh! A kick right across the temple.
The Enziguri, the head kick. Causes separation again. And again, Michaels has opportunity.
And here comes John Cena.
shoulder blocks, those tackles. Everything high impact coming from the WWE champion.
Explosive power.
Cena rings down. And look at this.
On Monday Night Raw, we saw John Cena hit the attitude adjustment on Randy Orton on top of Hell in a Cell. What does he have in store tonight for Legacy?
Enormous strength. John Cena picking up Legacy in total. Cena got high load. Cena's in trouble.
Cena is in big trouble. Who will prevail in this massive eight-man tag team main event? We're back here as we celebrate a decade of SmackDown. This is our main event. CM Punk going for the cover. One, two, no.
The world's champion got a near fall on the WWE champion. How often do you see this situation? Champion versus champion in this environment, a main event.
Come on. Oh, look out.
Viper Randy Orton, the number one contender with the WWE title, would love to name John Cena. Was giving Cena 48 hours to heel talk. Can be done.
Keep in mind, Jared, John Cena has never been in a Hell in a Cell match. They say you find the measure of a man sometimes. Will we find that measure Sunday night? It's Cena and Orton inside 5 tons of steel.
A vicious knee drop by Randy Orton. Now looking for a three count.
A cover here. One, two, and Cena powers out.
We talked earlier when we saw the U.S. champion, Intercontinental champion, as tag team partners about momentum and how important it is for this Sunday's Hell in a Cell pay-per-view to earn momentum. Not just have it fall in your lap, but to earn momentum. And that's what Randy Orton is trying to do here. Beat John Cena. How big would that be? 48 hours before Cena's first venture inside Hell in a Cell. Strength again.
Orton in an uncompromising situation, but that's how you counter, ladies and gentlemen. A perfect maneuver from Randy Orton. A DDT. Can he parlay it into a big win? No.
A sick DDT, and John Cena was able to literally will himself off the canvas. Orton has done tremendous damage to Cena, and now Orton giving Ted DiBiase the opportunity to continue to build his legacy, his confidence, and send another message, Todd, to DX.
And now DiBiase trying to pin the WWE champion in a kick out there from John Cena. And we know how confident Legacy is right now, JR. Can you imagine what they would be like if they were able to beat DX in Hell in a Cell?
I think Legacy is a big part of WWE's future. The question is, when will they become that huge part? It could be this Sunday. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. The question is, when is it going to happen?
Strength of John Cena. Walks right to the clothesline.
DiBiase got to go recover. And you can see the rage, the venom, the aggression spewing out the pores of Ted DiBiase. Thinking about this Sunday and what awaits him, the opportunity that awaits DiBiase and Rhodes, two of the most famous names in this entire industry, in the annals of WWE.
Cena!
Man, that Cena dances with Hook Brunning. As we say down in Oklahoma, he just goes back to that strength time and time again.
Well, Cena has promised to turn into a savage Sunday night in Hell in a Cell. Right now, though, he appears to be a mere mortal as he reaches out to tag one of his three partners.
Biggest tag, perhaps, of this main event coming up. Who can execute it? Who's going to get the tag? CM Punk and Triple H. The world's champion, CM Punk. And the incomparable Game. Nice high hard erase knee by Triple H.
And the choice of a new generation CM Punk is getting kneed all over by the Game, Triple H.
monster with authority, with impact, with velocity.
Taker wants in.
Oh, yeah.
And here we go.
And CM Punk
cowered out. He cowered out, and Orton's in.
CM Punk made the tag to Randy Orton. CM Punk wanted no part of The Undertaker, who's on fire, who's knitting the number one contender for the WWE title. Oh, look at The Undertaker with the explosion, the quickness, the devastation. Snake eyes. Oh, the grief. The demon of Death Valley is raging tonight.
The Undertaker and Orton. An equalizing move. Just when it appeared that The Undertaker was on his way to victory.
Oh, it's
Hell's Gate. It is Hell's Gate. It's now 100% legal.
And Cody Rhodes interrupted. Orton would have been tapping.
Well, it's Shawn Michaels. Just hit some sweet chin music. And look out, ladies and gentlemen. See you later.
And Orton catching Michaels from the blind side.
And now John Cena has CM Punk. Oh, right over the top rope on the Legacy. There are bodies flying everywhere.
That will address Punk's attitude. And look, oh my God, Randy Orton. Look where you are.
It's a lonely man's alley for Randy Orton.
And The Undertaker, the little man. Here it is. This is Tombstone Piledriver. And Randy Orton on this night will rest in peace. A man who emphatically said earlier tonight that he would, be the next heavyweight champion of the world.
And John Cena will venture into Hell in a Cell for the first time ever. What condition will Randy Orton be in after what we just saw? What a night, JR. What a night.
Who will be celebrating as we are celebrating tonight? A decade of SmackDown. Who will be celebrating and who will survive Hell in a Cell on pay-per-view this Sunday night?
Tell me what to do.